This is a Siemens Citrons LR400. It's a radar level transmitter. In this video we will see its connection. Here you can see one is positive and two is negative. It's 224 volt and 7 and 8 are milliamps output and 3 and 4 are digital output. It's a normally open contact. So here you can see its horn and its flange. Through this flange we can install it on any cello or a hopper. With this bolts and the flange we can fix it. This is its horn. From here it emit microwaves which are returned after colliding with the material, and the return time is equal to the level. This is its programmer. As you can see, it's different buttons. Mostly the left, right and up down buttons are used for the programming. This is a remote type, non-contact type programmer. So from a distance we can give program to the transmitter. Here you can see Siemens intrinsically safe programmer. Its model is 7ML58302AJ. The serial number you can see, and the different specs of this programmer are written here. I have made the supply yarns. As you can see, its model number Citrons LR400, and its total range was 3.7 meter. So at the start it will display like this. It will show its model number, then it will test its memory, that its memory is okay, all the parameters are safe. It will run the memory test, then it will run the self test. In self test it will check the on and the connection, and the all electronics are okay, parameters are okay, memory okay. So if the all is okay, then it will show the normal display. Here you can see it's showing plus 9.83 feet, and its dB is minus 1. So from here, from a distance we can communicate with this left button. We can go into the parameters. So I will press the left button. Here is the main menu. First is auto setup and auto setup. Second is display. This is a block. The third block is diagnostics. Fourth is device data. Fifth is options. And the sixth block is maintenance. So I will show you one by one what are the parameters inside this Siemens LR400 radar type level transmitter. This is a non-contact radar level transmitter. Here you can see first parameter is language, which is English. We can change it Dutch or English. I will select it English. With the right button I can save the parameter. This is the right button to save. So length unit is meter, inch, feet, millimeter and centimeter. With up and down I can navigate. So I will select the meter. Length unit is meter. This is the nozzle light. I will not change it. Nozzle light I will keep it 3.14 meter. Tank height where I will connect it is plus 12. I will change it. I want the 10 meter. So I will navigate, I will press up and down, and I will made the tank height to 10 meter because I want 10 meter height. So with the right button I will navigate, and up and down I will change it. With the right navigate up and down I will change it, and I will made it 10 meter. This is tank height. URV, that at which value I want the 20 milliamps, I can change it as per our requirement. Below than 10 meter, 9 meter, 8 meter, where I want, I can take 20 milliamps. So at that height it will show maximum level. I will made it 9.500. So this is the, now I will change the LRV. I want 4 milliamps at 0.35 level damping. This is set at 0.1 second. I will made it 1 second damping, and application type is shallow, solids or the liquid, or the liquid process or user tank. We can give it user tanks, but I will give it solids because I want to measure the level of solid material. So this is the first block, which is auto setup. Now I will go. If you like the video, you can subscribe my channel. Now I will go into the next block, which is our second block, and that is display. In display I will show you what are the parameters in this block, which is a display. With the right button I will go inside this display. As you can see, it selected multi display because it is showing level and noise. Second is, I want to display only level or mass or current output or the digital output, or I want multi display. Because I want multi display, so it's showing height and the noise ratio. Now I will show you the third block in the parameters. Well, I am showing you again the display. We can select if we want the current out. I want the current out 20 milliamps at the maximum. I want the current to the 20 milliamps. Now I will show you the first block is auto setup. As you can see, first block auto setup, and second is display. Here you can see multi display. I want to go into the third block, but I will show you all the other parameters. As you can see, the third block is diagnostics. In diagnostic we can diagnose the level transmitter if there is any problem, or we can check its status is okay or not. With the right button I will go into the diagnostics. Here you can see the first block is status. In status there is a wear, that how much our level is used, operating hours. You can see these are the hours this level sensor has operated. Second is the maximum temperature. It has worked up to the plus 67 centigrade. And the minimum temperature it has work is plus 9.25 centi. And the aging it has aged 25%. So 75% age is remaining. So it has not worked 85 degrees centigrade because its maximum temperature I showed you was 67. So in where we can check how many hours it we have used this transmitter. Second is the application. In application, no valid measurement. Third is the service MC. This is the service MC of this level transmitter. This is the service DSP. So these are the diagnostic parameter in this diagnostic block.